Hey guys, this is what we're doing. I'm Anne Intensity, and welcome back to my channel. Today we're having a special inside look. I know recently I've been doing some gaming videos over like the weekend and stuff like that, so I apologize if you aren't subscribed for that kind of content, but this series means so much to me. That's why I definitely want to cover it, because it took a long time to arrive, and it's made me immensely happy just to see it, just to get to play it finally, and I don't know, just it existing makes me really happy. But basically, Kingdom Hearts 3 came out yesterday, and I actually picked up the Deluxe Edition. So today we're having an inside look where I show you the cool ins and outs of cool anime or video game products. And today we're just going to be looking at the Deluxe Edition of Kingdom Hearts 3. So this is actually the box that it came in. Usually boxes like that come in like for Deluxe Edition games and stuff like that are like in similar styles. So like same kind of format, how it's a box like this, not made of like, you know, steel or anything. This is not the steel book. There is a steel book in here. But this box in particular, what really caught my eye as soon as I opened like the package was that it's actually like matte, you know? So it doesn't feel cheap, I guess you could say. Because other times, like boxes, they feel kind of cheap because of the material that they use to make the box. This box feels kind of matte and smooth. It's not like glossy or anything. The type of like paper or the material that they use to craft this box is much sturdier than I think other materials that I've seen other boxes be made out of. So that's really awesome, and I will show you a close up of this box first. So yes. So this is just for a closer look of the box. You can see how it's a little shiny where it says Kingdom Hearts 3. And the feel, like I said, the texture is very smooth. It's not like the glossy or cheap kind of paper. It feels really, really durable and just really nice. So while it's not like cardboard, it's still a really like sturdy material that they made this box out of. And then also, you really have to notice that there's so much like plaid. Like there's an obsession with plaid in Kingdom Hearts, so you can even see it on the sides. It's just an obsession with plaid. So once again, Deluxe Edition for PS4. The back is actually like, you know, it looks like the back actually looks like this. This was actually the area that had the pin in it, but I took it out. I already put it on display, so that's why the pin is no longer in there. But let's take a look at what's inside the box. Okay, so let's just open this. It opens from the side, and okay, there's a lot of cool goodies in here, and I think the first thing that I took out was, of course, the pin. That's why the pin isn't in here anymore. But the first thing I took out was actually the steelbook. And this steelbook is really nice. And like I said, Kingdom Hearts has an obsession with plaid. They love plaid. We see plaid all the time, especially in Kingdom Hearts 3. Now, they are really obsessed with plaid. I usually love steelbooks, and this is no exception, because honestly, it's beautiful. I can't wait to, when I complete the game, to stick the copy of the game in here, because I absolutely love steelbooks and I would love to have the game in this case. But just take a look at this. Ooh, this is pretty inside too. I like that. It's like some kind of like, I don't even know how to describe it. I need my glasses for this. Jeez. It's really interesting, and look at the reflection. Yeah, but it reminds me of like a chandelier or like gothic art. I don't know, but it looks really pretty, and I really just enjoy the details. But like I said, this is the other side of the steelbook. Once again, a lot of plaid, but it's shiny, it looks like brand new, and it's just a really nice thing. And I like the font that they chose for this too, how it says Kingdom Hearts there in the corner. Very, very nice. I have like a somewhat funny story. I guess it was sad at the time, for me at least. When I got the package yesterday, I was opening to play the game, getting everything out of the case, blah, blah, blah. And this was the first thing, like I said, this was the first thing that I took out. So I was like, oh yeah, I got the steelbook. So I actually opened the case and I was like, there's no game in here. Where's the game? So I was like,
this is some cruel joke from Amazon. They sent me the case with no game inside. So I was like, geez, this is how, like, really, my luck? You know, I have, like, EX bad luck. Not good luck, bad luck. So I was just like, oh no, I got the wrong, you know, I didn't get the item. I got everything, but the game isn't included. Like, what kind of deluxe edition is this? But I was dumb because there's actually the game in the regular case. So I was like, oh, I was just dumb. I should have taken a look at everything before I jumped to conclusion, because I was about to call Amazon and be like, you guys are cruel. You sent me a game case with no game inside. So, yeah, that's my embarrassing story of the week. So, yeah. So let's take a look at what else is in here. Like I mentioned before, this is the game. So this is a copy of the game. This is what's on sale if you go to, like, GameStop or anywhere else you're buying a copy of the game. This is the same case, same art, same everything. So I'm still glad that I got the steelbook. And then also inside, I don't have the disc in right now because I'm currently playing it. And you have some cool stuff. And ooh, do I get a code for a Square Enix store member thing? There's a code in here, product registration. Oh, I do that. So I didn't even see that at first. So I'm lucky I took that out. So this is just the standard copy of the game that you'll see in stores. So it was a relief to see after I took out that steelbook and saw that there was no disc in there. I was like, oh, okay. I see what they did. You would think that I would know that already, and why would I? But I love the art. Beautiful stuff. Great.
This is actually the pin that came with the game. So you can see Sora with his crown. Says Kingdom Hearts 3. It's a nice, decently sized pin. Fits great on my lanyard, so I really, really like it. And if you have already been collecting the pins from Kingdom Hearts, this is definitely a nice addition.
And last but not least, I do have to still show the pin. In the deluxe edition, you actually get this really cool art book. So I'm not sure how many pages it is. It says it in the back. Actually, it doesn't. It just says art book. So thanks a lot. It says 34 pages. So this is the cover. This is what you see when you start playing the game, where they're supposed to play Dearly Beloved, but they don't play Dearly Beloved. So this is the front of the book. Really, really nice illustration. But I gotta admit, I like the back cover more. Look at that. That is really cool. Just black and white art. No colorings or anything. Just line art, beautiful. I absolutely love that. Tetsuya Nomura does an excellent job drawing Sora. And inside this art book actually has, like, Sora's journey. It's like a little timeline of what's been going on. And then there's also, like, our characters. So you get to see everybody, the whole gang. The gang is here in their plaid outfits, especially Riku. Let's go with that. Yeah, woohoo. So, so you get to see everybody. And, Organization 13, so you get to see some pictures of your favorite organization members, you get to see the characters as they are in other worlds, and you also get some cool, ooh, this is really nice, this is like a two-page spread of the Big Hero 6 world, and then also characters from the Disney Pixar movies. Mike Wazowski is my favorite thing ever, so I'm really glad to see him in this game. Pirates of the Caribbean, Frozen, weapons, or keyblades. So this book is really, really handy, really cool, and just a nice addition to this deluxe edition. I just realized I said addition, like edition. I don't know. They both sound the same. But anyway, this deluxe edition of Kingdom Hearts 3 is definitely amazing. I really like what it included, and just to have the game finally, after years, is such a great feeling. And I'm not even in Toy Box yet. I'm, like, taking my time. I'm taking my sweet time. I just made it to Twilight Town. So, and it took me, like, a good half hour to get there because I couldn't fly that gummy ship. So, good luck to me with the rest of the game and try to get places because, good luck. So, honestly, definitely pick up Kingdom Hearts 3 if you have played any of the other games and enjoyed them. I know that the series means a lot to me. I know it means a lot to many, many people. So I hope that you get a chance to pick up the game for yourself and play the game for yourself. And I hope you guys enjoy this inside look and just getting to see what the deluxe edition has inside. I really recommend this edition if you are a really huge Kingdom Hearts fan, especially if you like the art, if you like steelbooks. I love steelbooks. I live for steelbooks. So that's why I really wanted this edition, because I like steelbooks, I like art books, and I know a lot of people also collect pins. I don't really collect pins, but now I kind of have a little like lanyard filled with pins like I showed before. So the pin is really, really nice, and this whole edition is really, really cool. So definitely check out Kingdom Hearts 3 if you have not already. I know it just came out, so it's going to take some time for everyone to get it and get their first impressions of the game, but feel free to comment below and let me know which edition of Kingdom Hearts you got, and if you got the Deluxe Edition, did you enjoy what's inside it, and did you enjoy this video? I don't know. And if you've been playing the game, have you been enjoying it so far? Anyway, thank you guys so much for watching. Totally, totally appreciate it. Please like, share, or subscribe if you liked this video, and I will see you guys next time.